alaikum. What do we say when someone says? So, salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. All right, let me introduce myself. My name is Iman Kurtam, and I am an author. Who knows what an author does? Writes books. So I write children's books, and I actually write real life stories that happened with me and my kids. I have two kids, Zainuddin and Maryam, and my stories are called Zain and Nima's Adventures. Maryam's sitting right over there. Say hi. So I wrote a book. I think I came here maybe a couple months ago to tell you about my first book, which is Stand for Palestine. Oh, who saw it? Did it? You have that book? You have that too? Does anyone else have it? The book, Stand for Palestine? You read it? Okay. Well, my second book is called The Best Ramadan. And this story is actually a real life thing that me and my kids have done. But today, I have a surprise for you guys.
The buzzer.
Do you guys know what the buzzer is? So, I'm going to have a little competition. Before I get into the story time, I'm going to talk a little bit about Ramadan. And I want you guys to pay attention. I'll tell you, wait, hold on. So, if you guys want to pay attention, that's how you're going to answer the questions for the competition. I'm actually going to ask you to move a little bit backwards. You can just pick it up and move a little bit backwards. Because we're going to be running a little bit, okay? All right, are you ready to start?
Yes.
I heard one yes. Who else is going to say yes? Are you guys ready to start?
Yes!
All right, let's go. First of all, we're going to talk about a little bit about myself. I'm Egyptian, by the way, so I'm going to say a little things that we do in Egypt to celebrate Ramadan. Are you guys ready? Now.
Mecca.
First of all, we want to talk a little bit about Ramadan. Who knows what is Ramadan? What is Ramadan? I'm going to ask you. It's a month. What happened in that month? What's so special that has happened in that month? Yeah.
Muhammad.
Prophet Muhammad. Something's happened with Prophet Muhammad in that month. Yes. Do you know?
He tells us to send Allah's message to fast.
To fast. We do fast in that month of Ramadan. Yes. What else happened?
We fast because we can feel how the Lord.
That's one of the reasons. That's not exactly, but it's one of the reasons. Yes. The Quran was revealed. So I want you guys to pay attention because this is going to come in the little competition we're going to have later. So what happened in Ramadan? Ramadan is the ninth month of the Islamic calendar. How many? What's the month? What number?
Nine.
The ninth month of the Islamic calendar. Oh, do you? Should I just use this mic instead?
Yeah, I agree. Okay, I'm going to give it to you.
Give me that mic. Use that mic. Thank you.
Can you guys hear me? Yes. All right, this is better. Okay, so Ramadan is the ninth month of the Islamic calendar. And something very special happened in this month. The Quran was revealed to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now, I have a question for you guys. This is a bonus question. Who knows what was the first word that was revealed to Prophet Muhammad in the Quran? I'll ask you. Iqra. Iqra. What does Iqra mean? Read. So as an author, I love that, right? Because that's the first thing Allah tells us is to read. Now, so the Ramadan is the ninth month of the Islamic calendar. The Quran was revealed in that month. And the first word that was revealed in the Quran was Iqra. Now, Ramadan is the month of mercy and kindness. Who knows what happens in this month of mercy and kindness when we do good deeds? Who here does not fast in Ramadan or is still a little too young to fast in Ramadan?
Me?
Me? Yeah. You met him? So maybe sometime. No. So actually, This is something important that this book is all about. It's, remember I told you, it's called The Best Ramadan. And the idea of it is sometimes we focus too much about fasting, but there are lots of other good things that we can do in Ramadan. Okay? And the best way to celebrate Ramadan is to be on your absolute best behavior in everything. We read Quran, we pray, we listen to our parents, we smile, we remember to be grateful. All of these things are ways we can celebrate Ramadan without, not only with fasting. So this book, The Best Ramadan, this is what it focuses about. It focuses on how we can get the best Ramadan, even if we are not fasting. Okay? Now, we already said that Ramadan is the 9th month of the Islamic calendar. Who knows how we find out when Ramadan has started? Do you know? By the moon. What does the moon look like? Can you see it in the picture over here? What does the moon look like? Can you come and point to the correct moon? Come up here. Is it going to be a full moon?
No.
No? What is it going to be? A crescent. And you know what? I hear that today the MCCR, you guys are going to go outside and we're going to try and look at the moon. And that's exactly how they did it a long time ago. Before there were phones, before there were calendars, you know what they would do? They would get their lanterns, just like this. It wasn't exactly like this. It had a light inside, and Muslims, a little bit la. And the Muslims would go out in the middle of the night and follow the light inside the lantern and go up on a hill and look at the sky. And they would try to wait and see the moon. Some days the moon would be too cloudy, and so they can't see the moon, and so they say, oh no, Ramadan has not started, so they have to come back. And some days they go out and they look up at the moon and they see it, they see the crescent. How do you think they felt when they saw the crescent?
Happy.
They were happy. They started to celebrate. They were singing. They were so upset. I mean, so happy because, not upset, the opposite of upset. They were so excited because Ramadan, the month of mercy, has started. Now, I want us to pretend that we are like that. I want everyone to stand up. Yes. And we are holding our lanterns. We're walking out in the middle of the night. We look up at the sky and we see the moon and we are so excited. And so, I want you guys to follow me. We're going to celebrate. We just saw the Ramadan moon. Now follow me in a line, okay? Ramadan moon. All right. Everyone come up. One second. All right, we're going to skip now, okay? The people are coming and going, riding, toing and froing.
World tonight,
people are so excited. Starting up soon, over to see the moon, hoping to catch a sight. Everyone's so happy. Moon, moon, come out soon. We're off to see the Ramadan moon. Fogs lift, fogs lift. We're off to see the Ramadan moon tonight. Now, how to start it. It's just been sight. Tomorrow we all fast. All right, everyone, stay over here. We're gonna clap, okay?
The Quran is in his heart.
The Quran is in his heart. Moon, moon, come out soon. We're off to see the Ramadan. We're off to see the Ramadan moon. Tonight. All right, everyone, take a seat.
Okay.
That was fun, huh? Now, then we celebrated and we saw the Ramadan moon. Remember I told you guys I was, where was I from?
Egypt.
I'm Egyptian. And so there is something called El Musahharati. Can you guys say the Musahharati?
Musahharati.
And the Musahharati in Egypt has a special job. You know what his job is? It's to wake up everyone in the middle of the night to have suhoor. Who knows what suhoor is? Who can tell me what is suhoor? Anyone know? I'll ask you.
When you wake up and you eat, so you can fast later on without being hungry.
Exactly. So suhoor is a meal you have before the sun rises so that you can fast the next day. Now, I want you guys to pretend with me that you are the Musahharati. Your job is to wake up everyone to have suhoor. Are you ready? I'm going to show you how he does it. He has a drum that's a lot bigger than this one, but we're going to use this one for show. And he has a special drum. Are you ready? Okay. I want you guys to clap like him, okay? One, two, three. It's Hayanim, Wahid Dayim. It's Hayanim, Wahid Dayim. Now, what basically, I'm just going to do a loose translation here. What that means is, wake up, sleepyhead. It's time to worship Allah. Now, we had suhoor, the Musahharati came. Do you guys want to do it one more time? I want you to clap as loud as you can. Try to wake everyone up. Are you ready? You could do it. One, two, three. It's Hayanim. Wahid Dayim. All right. Now that we pretended to be the Musahharati, we wake everyone up and we have our suhoor. What happens the next day? The first day of Ramadan, what happens? That's when the grown-ups, they fast. From what time do we fast? Who can tell me? Do we fast from Dhuhr till Asr?
No, Isha!
Isha? No! From Fajr to where? What time? To Maghrib. So we fast from Fajr to Maghrib, or from sunrise to sunset. Okay? Now, can we drink water if we fast?
No.
Can we eat pizza?
No.
So we try our best to not eat or drink all day. Now, who knows why do we do that? Why do we fast? What is it? Okay, who knows why we fast? So one of the good things that happens is, yes, you feel like what other people are feeling. That's a very good thing that comes out of it. But is that the reason why we do it? No. What's the reason?
So you could, like, if there's, like, yeah, it's basically she said, I don't know, really.
No, let me tell you something. Okay, I'll ask last person. Tell me. To be grateful. That is one of the very good things that comes out of fasting. But that's not why we fast. One, I'll answer right now, okay? One, we fast because Allah told us to fast. Two, Allah says, when we fast, that brings us taqwa. Can you say that word? Taqwa. And basically, what taqwa means is sometimes when our tummies are empty, our hearts are full with the remembrance of Allah. We remember Allah in everything we do because we're not focused on our bodies or eating all the best things. We let go of everything and we just remember Allah. And so next time someone asks you, why do we fast? We fast because it brings us taqwa. It makes our heart filled with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay?
No.
Now, are you guys ready to hear my story? I think I'm gonna go home. I don't feel like you guys are excited. Are you guys ready to hear the story? All right, that's better. It's called The Best Ramadan by Iman Kurtam. That's me. And illustrated by Sophia Sulaiman. Do you guys want to move a little bit this way so you can see the... Yeah. Okay, so if you guys want to see, if you guys want to scoot it down a little bit. It's not the same as if you see it like from the big screen. Are you ready? The sun has set. Baba, Mama, Zain, and Nima cuddle as they look at the sky. Will the Ramadan moon come out tonight? Or will it only be the stars sparkling so bright? It's hard to see if the thin crescent appears, but Baba checks the news, and Zain and Nima start to cheer. Ramadan is here! Ramadan is here! Let's cheer together. One, two, three.
Ramadan is here! Ramadan is here!
They grab their lanterns and sing their favorite Ramadan songs, then decorate the whole house with a string of lights that is oh so long. Now it's time to make suhoor. Tomorrow, Baba and Mama will start to fast from sunrise to sunset without food or water. They must last. Can we fast too? Pleaded the kids. Mama said, you can give it a go, but there are other good deeds to do in Ramadan, you know. Ramadan is the month the Quran was revealed. That's why it's filled with mercy and kindness. The best way to celebrate it is to practice being our finest. So remember to always wear that beautiful smile on your face, even when you're meeting new people, even if you're a little shy while greeting new people at a new place. Now I'm going to ask you, everyone, look at me and show me your sunnah smiles. Your sunnah smile. You get good deeds when you show me that sunnah smile. Yes. So even that little sunnah smile, when you see someone, you get good deeds for. When you're both super hungry and there's only one pair, don't fight over who will take it. And remember to be kind and share. So next time you guys have a favorite toy and you don't want to give it, you just don't want to share, remember that if in Ramadan, if you share, you get good deeds. Now, if you make a big mistake and you're scared of others' reactions, be brave and tell the truth. Allah loves honesty in our actions. So even if you're feeling worried or scared, take a deep breath and just say the truth, inshallah. Again, this Ramadan, something very important to try to do. This one. When you're feeling upset and want to scream and shout, take a deep breath and relax and calmly try to figure it out. So you guys, I want you guys to remember this Ramadan. If something makes you so mad, you're going to try to calm down. And I want you guys to show me how you're going to take your deep breaths. It's in from the nose. Keep it in. And then blow out. As if you're blowing a candle. Let's try again. In from the nose. Keep it in, and then blow out. Now, remember that. Next time someone makes fun of you, or someone makes you so mad, or breaks your toy by mistake, you're going to get so mad. You're going to take your deep breath and control your anger. This Ramadan. When Baba and I ask you to clean up your room, even though you don't want to, it's best to go find the broom. Now, how many times does your mom or dad ask you to clean up your room? Yes? A little bit? This time, instead of saying, no, I don't want to, you're going to remember, right? If I listen to my parents, I'm going to get good deeds this Ramadan. So, and we know Ramadan is the month of mercy and kindness. So if you do one good deed, Allah will multiply and multiply and multiply. What else are we going to do? Don't forget to pay attention to the words of Ar-Rahman. Who knows who Ar-Rahman is? Who is Ar-Rahman? Who? Yeah. Allah. Ar-Rahman is another name for Allah. So what is the words of Ar-Rahman? Where do we find them? What is the words of Ar-Rahman? Uh-huh. It's the Quran. So don't forget to pay attention to the words of Ar-Rahman. You must read, learn, and practice reciting the Quran. Remember to set the alarm with the adhan 5 times a day. What do we do 5 times a day? Who knows? What do we do? We pray. When you hear it, make wudu, because now it's time to pray. If you have a dream or a wish that hasn't happened yet, raise your hands and make dua. You'll be amazed by what you get. Now, everyone show me the way we raise our hands to make dua. How do we make dua? Do we make dua like this or like this? Or how do we make it? Show me. Like this. So, now I'm going to take a pause here for a moment. And I want to remember something. And I want us all to remember together. I'm wearing this today. Because we have to remember that even though here we are safe and alhamdulillah we are happy, we are starting the blessed month, we have some brothers and sisters who are struggling right now, who may not find in Palestine, who may not find food, who might not find shelter, who might not find water. So I want us to take a few seconds. Let's do it together. Let's raise our hands and make dua for our brothers and sisters in Palestine right now. Ya Rab. Say it behind me. Say it with me, okay? Ya Rab.
Ya Rab.
Give our brothers and sisters in Palestine. Give them shelter. Ya Rab, give them food. Ya Rab, give them water. Ya Rab, give them safety. Ya Rab, give them liberation. Ya Rab, give them freedom. And I want us to try to remember them all through this month in Ramadan. While we make dua for ourselves, for our friends, for our families, we will not forget our brothers and sisters in Palestine right now. Okay? Now, at the end of a long day, be grateful and think about all of Allah's blessings. They are too many to count. Now, here's something we have to remember. Actually, I have a question for you. How many times have you and your family gone out, gotten lovely food together, played, you had a lovely day, and then you came home and you still wanted more, or you got upset about something small? Instead of remembering to be thankful about everything Allah gave you that day. Has that happened to you? I know that has happened to me. Anyone else? Yeah? So I want us to remember this Ramadan to look around us and be grateful for everything that happens. Small things, big things, we're going to be grateful, inshallah. And who knows what happens when we're grateful to Allah, when we say alhamdulillah, who knows? Allah gives us hasanat, but he also gives us more. When we keep thanking Allah, he gives us more. Okay? Now, do you guys think you can do these things we just talked about?
Yeah?
Yeah? I don't feel like you guys are super sure. Are you guys sure you can do it?
Yeah.
Yes? Do you think you can do it? I know you can. And Allah will reward you more than you ever planned. Zain and Nima got so excited. We can do it. We can do it, they said. We will be the best that we can be for 30 days ahead. How many days are in a month? Who knows?
31.
30 sometimes, sometimes 31, sometimes. But mainly, let's just say 30. So for 30 days ahead in Ramadan. What happens after Ramadan? And when we are done, it will be time for fun. Ramadan, because after Ramadan, Eid always comes. Exactly. At sunrise the next day, Zain and Nima got hung up their Ramadan calendars. They used them to count the days until Eid and remind themselves with their Ramadan manners. Only with the best Ramadan manners can we really have the best Ramadan. Join Zain and Nima with their plan, with your planners, and color the boxes at dusk and at dawn. Now, this book is going to be here at the MCC. Brother Munir ordered so many copies. Alhamdulillah, you guys can buy it from here. Or it's also available on Amazon. And what's so... No, it's not free. You have to buy it. And then at the very end of the book, there's a calendar. And it's in the calendar, you're supposed to color in every box of every good deed we talked about. So did you remember to have your sunnah smile? Did you remember to share? Did you remember to be honest? All of these different things. And we try our best to do that so we can have the best Ramadan. And that's why there's a one here. It's like, we want to be number one. It's a competition. We want to try and be our best. That's my story, and now after the 30 days are done, it will be Eid, and we will celebrate. Before we go, I want to talk to you guys a little bit about Eid. Who knows why Allah gave us Eid to celebrate? Who knows? Why did Allah give us Eid? Yes. Exactly, because we fasted, we tried our best to be on our best behavior. Allah rewards us with Eid. Allah rewards us with Eid. When you do so much good work, subhanAllah, Allah always rewards us. And who knows how we celebrate Eid? I'm going to ask you guys, how do we celebrate Eid? Do you guys know? Huh? Give me one way we celebrate. One way we celebrate with Eid. No, we don't fast. We fasted for 30 days after Eid. What do we do? Okay, in the green shirt. How do we celebrate Eid? So, yes, we go to the masjid. We see our friends and we pray the Eid prayer. That's one way we celebrate Eid. What else? How do we celebrate Eid?
There's also like some face paints and
yes, we celebrate. There's face paint. We try to go to festivals. What else do we do in Eid?
Gifts.
Yes, gifts. Who gets money for Eid? Sometimes we get money. Yes, idea. Sometimes we get a toy. So what about clothes? What we wear our old clothes in Eid, or we buy new clothes? So yes, what do you want to say, my love? Yes, we do. So Eid, we celebrate by wearing new clothes. And it's all a big celebration because we've worked so hard for 30 days. And these are the things that we do in Ramadan and Eid. Are you guys ready for our game?
Yeah.
Yes? Okay, so I'm going to go around. I'm going to say the numbers from 1 to 5 to anyone who wants to play. And I'm going to ask a question, and we're going to have this buzzer right here. We're going to have a buzzer right here. We're going to put it, and I'm going to have lines. I'm going to ask a question, and the first person in each line is supposed to run up and answer the buzzer and click the buzzer. And if he gets it, he gets to answer the question. If he answers the question correct, he gets a little candy. Are you guys ready? Jolly Rancher. All right, so I'm going to get the buzzer right here. And anyone who wants to play, to stand up. If you want to play, stand up. Yeah, but you guys have to stand still. I'm gonna say numbers. So number one is going to come. You're number one. Come behind me. When I say one, you're going to come and stand after her, okay? And you're going to be number two. Okay. So you're going to stand over here. Sorry. And you're going to be number three. Yes, come over here. And you're going to be number four.
And the final person is going to be number 5. You're going to stand over here. No, come over here. Now I'm going to say the numbers, and you're going to have to go stand next to the correct person, okay? So you're 1. 1, 2. Go to 1. Go to 1. Go to 2. Stand behind her. 3. Go behind 3. Oh, do you want to play? No. 4. Go behind 4. Do you want to play? 5. Go behind 5. If you want to play, go behind 1. Go behind 2. Go to 2. 2's over there. Come on. 3. Go behind 3. Go behind 4. Go behind 5. You don't want to play? You want to play? Go behind 1. Go behind 2. Go behind 3. Go behind 4. Go behind 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. This one. 2. 5 is right here. 5. I'll tell you again. So go behind 5. 1. You want to do? 2. Go behind 2. 3. Go behind 3. Now I'm going to ask anyone else on the floor who doesn't want to play to please give us some space. So can you go, everyone go who doesn't want to play, go over there and maybe take the chairs with you. All right, thank you so much. Okay, now I want you to take steps back, 4 steps back maybe.
This is my
4
steps back over.
I wanna. Sorry, thank you. Are you guys ready?
Yeah.
Let me get my notebook with the questions. And here's the buzzer. Now I want you guys to touch the couch. Go very far. Yeah, you guys have to be in the same line. Okay. All right. So the first participants come over here. Just come this way. Yes, stand here. Stand here. Exactly. So he's not here, my love. Okay, are you number 1? No, you're number 1, right? Yeah, come over here. Okay, so these are the, can you go back? You have to stand behind 2. Okay. All right, come closer. Okay, I'm going to ask you the first question. All right, get ready to run. Get ready. Wait, not yet. When I say go. The first question I'm going to ask you is, Ramadan is which month of the Islamic calendar? What number? What number? Run. Okay, she got it.
9.
Good job. Now you're going to give, you get candy to all your team. Go back to the end of the line. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So go back to the end of the line. All right, team 1 has already started. Let's go. Nope, take a step back. My love, team 1, come here. Okay, come on. Come over here. Okay. So I'm going to ask the question of... Okay, go back to the end of the line. You got ready to run, okay? Did you go the first time? Oh, you have to go in the back, and then she comes up. Yeah. Okay. All right, now you guys are on the same. Wait, if you already did it, you have to go back, someone else. So you didn't run the first time? I asked the question, okay. Okay, so I can see them now. Let's go ahead. How do we know that the month of Ramadan started? How do we know? Yes, good job. That's number 4, right? You got 4.
No, I'm number 3.
3? Okay, go back. Okay. Now, someone. Okay. Oh, my love, come here. Come up, come up. Yes, okay. So I'm going to ask you the question of what happened that made Ramadan a special month? What happened? Yes, good job. Not made, revealed. Yes, but yes, good job. Take some. All right. Are you ready? Let's. Hold on. Sorry, 1 second. I need to find my questions. Yes, okay. Okay, tell me. Two ways to celebrate Ramadan that's not fasting. Okay, what are two ways?
You could give money
to the poor.
Yeah, to the poor, and you could buy new clothes.
No, buy new clothes is an Eid. Okay. Something else. In Ramadan, what do we do?
We share our toys. We can share toys.
Share toys? Yes. One. What else? One more. What do we talk about in the book?
We could. Give a smile.
Yes, good job. Team number one. Okay, get some and give them to your team. All right. How long in Ramadan do people fast? From what to what? How long? Yeah. All right. 30 days. 30 days. Yeah, that's correct too. Okay, I'm going to give it to you. Okay, 30. There are 30 days in a month, yes. Can you give enough for your team?
Yes.
All right, go back. Okay, now I'm going to talk about the one day in Ramadan. When do you start fasting and when do you stop fasting? Go. Ah. When do you start? When do you stop?
You start at the first day of Ramadan.
No, on the day of Ramadan, the one day. When did you start? What time of the day?
Suhoor.
So suhoor, but like before Fajr. Before Fajr
till the sun goes down.
Which is Maghrib. Yes, good job. Wait, let me get you enough for your team. Is that enough for everyone? Okay. Hi, my love. I'll give you at the very end, okay? Go back. I feel bad. Okay, can you guys focus and run? I'm gonna start asking the because I want you guys to run. Now. Okay. What comes after Ramadan? Yes, what comes after Ramadan?
An Eid.
Eid, yes, good job.
Both,
that's correct. Now, okay, my final question, give me, okay, take steps back, okay, my final question, give me two ways we can celebrate Eid. Yes, good job. What are two ways to celebrate Eid?
We can get new clothes.
Get new clothes is one. Yes, one more.
Eat sweets.
Yes, good job. All right, that's enough. I know. Okay, well, if you don't want, you can give and share. All right. Now, before I go, I want to make sure that everyone gets a Jolly Rancher. Did you guys enjoy the story? Yes, I really hope you did. If you guys did, keep an eye out. With Brother Munir is going to have these books here at the MCC. And I just want to say Ramadan Mubarak. Jazakumullah khairan.